So this week, I was finally back in the cinema after the second lockdown, and it was so great to be back with a socially distanced audience, of course, and wearing a mask. But I went to see this film called Supernovas. It's a film starring Colin Firth and Stanley Tucci. It's centered around a gay couple who go on a road trip, and they're trying to come to terms with Stanley Tucci's character's Tusker's developing dementia. Colin Firth plays a character called Sam. He's a very successful concert pianist. And Stanley Tucci plays a character called Tusker, who's a very successful novelist. So they're trying to come to terms with Tusker's diagnosis and their relationship and each other. And they go back to Sam's family home to reconnect with friends and family. It's a bit of a coincidence because just before I went to see this film, I was listening to the radio and I was listening to an interview with a woman describing how she's coping with her husband's dementia. And then it was strange to go to see this film straight afterwards. And that interview, the real life interview, was so heartbreaking. And so when I went to see this, I really wanted to be moved as well and to feel the same way and connect to the characters. Now, it is a very moving film in parts. But I did find that it lagged a little bit, and the film came across like a two-hander play. I didn't know it was going to be a road movie until the opening shot, and I was a little bit worried because sometimes road movies can be brilliant and really interesting or really, really boring. And I think you need a bit of sense of humour in them to keep them going, keep the momentum up. But with this, I know the topic is very sensitive, but they could have injected a little bit more humour in it, so it wouldn't have dragged so much. But saying that though, there is very moving moments in it. There's one moment where Sam goes out to and he finds Tusker's novel he's working on, and the first page is beautiful handwriting, and then when he goes through the pages, handwriting gets worse and worse until it becomes scribbles and becomes illegible. And it was such a beautiful creative moment to demonstrate the development and how of Tusker's dementia and how it's getting worse and worse, and he's hiding it as well from Sam. So that was a really creative way of telling that without saying it. Another beautiful moment is when they're all sitting around having dinner with friends and family, and Tusker gets up to make a speech about how much Sam means to him, but he's finding it difficult to find the words and finish the speech. So he gives it over to Sam to finish it, and it's so beautiful. It's such a beautiful moment. The one thing is, I just found Tusker's character to be very self-indulgent and very selfish in parts, and I didn't feel as moved as I wanted to with his character. I didn't connect to him as much. But on the other side of things, Sam played by Colin Firth. Well, I Colin Firth and Hugh Grant, they've aged so well. It's so lovely to see Colin Firth really showing what a brilliant actor he is. His performance in this is mesmerizing. It's so subtle and it's such internal acting. And there's one moment where it's up close shot of Sam's face and you just see a tear rolling down his cheek. Another highlight from the film is the scenery. It really shows the scenery off really well. I think it's filmed in the Lake District, but there's one point where they go to a house and you see a mountain outside, and it shows the countryside really well. But overall, I found it dragged a lot. It didn't move me as much as I wanted to. But the one thing you should go see this film for is Colin Firth and his performance. Now, it is, I feel like it's an Oscar bait film. It's something that probably will win loads of awards because it's ticking a lot of the boxes. Something you'd go to see in a cinema in an afternoon. Or maybe late at night at the film festival. It wouldn't be for everyone. I know it's getting really good reviews. It is a really good film and people will enjoy it. But for me, because it dragged a little bit and I didn't connect as much as I wanted to, I would give it a 3 out of 5. So Supernova is coming to cinemas next year on the 5th of March nationwide.